Hello students, welcome to EPG Pakshala. I'm Dr. Sanjala Babuta from Department of Pharmaceutics, Faculty of Pharmacy, Jamia Hamdard. Today, we are going to discuss about a module, Shaving Products and Aftershave Preparation under the paper Cosmetics. The objective of this module is to make you know about the shaving products, characteristics of a good shaving product, the basic ingredients of a shaving product, shaving soaps, shaving creams, brushless shaving cream, shaving gels, aftershave preparations, which includes aftershave lotion, crackling foam, aerosol aftershave lotion, aftershave gels, aftershave creams, packaging of these shaving products, and evaluation of these shaving products. So, every day, a man removes around 20,000 to 25,000 of terminal hair, protruding 250 to 500 micrometer from the skin at angles of 30 to 60 degrees and covering a facial area of 250 centimeter square. To minimize the trauma of shaving, a wide variety of preparations are now available that prepare the beard and face for shaving, increase the speed and comfort during shaving, and confer a feeling of well-being after shaving. The choice of selecting shaving product depends upon the individual that which type of preparation is required for shaving. Beard softening. Beard softening results from the variations in the mechanical properties of hair by the absorption of water. At 100% relative humidity, hair absorbs about 31% of its dry weight of water. The hydration of hair is improved by increase in temperature. However, views differ on the time taken by the hair to hydrate completely. This ranges from 2 minutes at room temperature as measured by the force required to cut the beard hair to 2.5 to 3 minutes at 49 degrees centigrade, as measured by the creep of scalp hair extrapolated to the thicker beard hair to 6 minutes at 43 degrees centigrade, as measured by the changes in the elasticity of hair. The established view on beard softening is based on measurement of the creep and elasticity of hair, supported by practical shaving test. This suggests that the rate of softening of the beard can be increased by addition of a wetting agent to the water, by increasing the pH of the aqueous phase, and by the removal of sebum from the hair. Skin lubrication. There is little literature on the contribution of skin lubrication to the speed, comfort, and closeness of shaving. It has been demonstrated that plastic material exhibit lower friction on dry, greasy, or very wet skin. However, more friction is required if the skin is simply moist. Moreover, skin friction is decreased by mineral oil, surfactants, and silicone fluids. One can only consider the mechanism of lubrication by the product, as it depends on the load applied to the razor, the area of contact with the face, the velocity of razor across the face, and the viscosity of preparations. At high load per unit area and low shaving speed, boundary lubrication is likely to predominate, so that for a coefficient of friction, the shaving preparation should have a high viscosity and should form a condensed film. At low load per unit area and high shaving speed, hydrodynamic lubrication is likely to predominate. The viscosity of the shaving preparation should be high enough to give a film thickness sufficient to prevent rough contact, but thereafter the viscosity should be as low as possible. Shaving products. Each day, men removes 20,000 to 25,000 of terminal hair protruding 250 to 500 micrometer from the skin at angles of 30 to 60 degrees and covering a facial area of 250 square centimeter. To minimize the trauma of shaving, a wide range of preparations are now available that prepare the beard and the face for shaving, increase the speed and comfort during shaving, and confer a feeling of well-being after shaving. The choice of selecting shaving products depends upon the individual that which type of preparation is required for shaving. Before we start with the shaving products, first of all, let us understand what is beard softening. Beard softening results from the variations in the mechanical properties of hair by the absorption of water. At 100% relative humidity, hair absorbs about 31% of its dry weight of water. The hydration of hair is improved by increasing temperature. However, views differ on the time taken by the hair to hydrate completely. This ranges from 2 minutes at room temperature as measured by the force required to cut the beard hair to 2.5 to 3 minutes at 49 degrees centigrade as measured by the creep of scalp hair extrapolated to the thicker beard hair to 6 minutes at 43 degrees centigrade as measured by the changes in the elasticity of hair. The established view on beard softening is based on measurements of the creep and elasticity of hair supported by practical shaving tests. This suggests that the rate of softening of the beard can be increased by the addition of a wetting agent to the water, by increasing the pH of the aqueous phase, and by removal of sebum from the hair. Skin lubrication. There is little literature on the contribution of skin lubrication to the speed, comfort, and closeness of shaving. It has been demonstrated that plastic material exhibits low friction on dry, greasy, or very wet skin. However, more friction is required if the skin is simply moist. Moreover, skin friction is decreased by mineral oil, surfactants, and silicone fluids. One can only consider the mechanism of lubrication by the product as it depends on the force applied to the razor, the area of contact with the face, the velocity of razor across the face, and the viscosity of preparations. At high load per unit area and low shaving speed, boundary lubrication is likely to predominate so that for a coefficient of friction, the shaving preparation should have a high viscosity and should form a condensed film. At low load per unit area and high shaving speed, hydrodynamic lubrication is likely to be predominant. The viscosity of the shaving preparation should be high enough to give a film thickness sufficient to prevent rough contact, but thereafter the viscosity should be as low as possible. The various kinds of shaving products that are commonly used are shaving soaps, shaving creams, shaving foams, and shaving gels. Characteristics of good shaving product. The main characteristic features of shaving products are to support the beard hair, to soften the beard, and to lubricate the passage of the blade over the face. In addition, it should be capable to produce a rich, copious lather. It should be non-irritant. It should exhibit good wetting properties. It should be soft, smooth, and free from lumps. It should easily adhere to both face and brush. It should get easily removed from face and blade on rinsing. It should exhibit satisfactory consistency and texture, which should be maintained at normal storage conditions. It should assist in the removal of shaving debris. It should be stable over a range of temperature. It should be resistant to rapid collapse and drying out, and it should be non-corrosive to the blade. The basic ingredients of shaving products. The following are the main ingredients present in the formula of a shaving product. Number one, bases or the saponification agents. Triethanolamine, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide are examples of the saponification agent which saponify the fatty acids. Sodium hydroxide facilitates creation of harder soaps. On the other hand, softer soap is produced by potassium hydroxide, which could be easily loaded on the brush. Mono and diethanolamines are used occasionally because they may cause skin irritation. Triethanolamine soaps create closer knit foams than the potassium soaps. Fatty acids. Saturated long chain fatty acids, that is consisting of 12 to 18 carbon atoms, are key ingredients of soap. Lower molecular weight fatty acids such as coconut oil leads to skin irritation. To produce lather with different physical properties, the content of fatty acid is varied accordingly. Stearic acid is an example of fatty acid which is commonly used. If used in high content, it gives a stiffer and more stable, dense lather. Lauric acid produces softer foam and improves the expulsion properties. Surfactants. These are usually added with the aim to improve the emulsion stability, wetting properties, and emolliency. A wide variety of non-ionic and anionic surfactants are employed, including lauryl sulfates, sodium lauryl ether sulfate, lauric diethylamide, and ethoxylated lanolins. Emollients, they are used as moisturizer to soften the skin. They are added to relieve skin dryness, wrinkling, irritation, and scaling of the skin. Few examples of emollients are polyoxyethylene, glyceryl cocate, glycerin, lanolin derivatives, and fatty acid esters. Lanolin derivatives are also used to mix immiscible substances and to retain the moisture in the skin. Humectants, they act as moisturizer and lubricants. Glycerin, sorbitol, and propylene glycol are polyols which are commonly added to shaving preparation which renders the skin soft. The level of these agents is about 2-3% in the preparation. These agents act as moisturizer and lubricant. They also help in reducing the tendency of foam to dry out on the face. Lubricants, mineral oil, vegetable oils like palm oil, coconut oil, lanolin and isopropyl myristate are generally added to shaving preparations in order to assist the passage of blade over the face and to provide lubrication. Moreover, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, polyvinyl pyrrolidone and polyacrylic acids are used to improve the lather stability and to provide lubrication. Perfume. Soap compatible perfumes are generally used in order to avoid any deterioration in the final product. The level of perfume to be used in the preparation ranges between 0.15-0.65%. Cooling agents. These agents are used to counteract the afterglow associated with shaving. Menthol is commonly used for the cooling effect in the concentration range of 0.05 to 0.2%. The cooling effect can last for 5 to 15 minutes after the application. A group of chemicals from carboxamides to ureas to phosphine oxides exhibit physiological cooling action. Pilomotor agents. Pilomotor activity is the potential to cause the contraction of the erector's pilorum, known as the hair follicle muscle. The contraction of the hair follicle muscles causes hair to be pushed farther above the skin by about 0.2 to 0.3 millimeter so that it is easy to cut the hair in the elevated portion, which will retract below the skin surface as the follicle muscle gets relaxed. Various substances are used for as pilomotor agents. It is claimed that a closer shave can be obtained by incorporating pilomotor agents into the shaving products. The various additional agents like opacifying agents, example titanium dioxide, plant extracts like neem, proteins, vitamins, antioxidants, preservatives like methyl and propyl, para-hydroxybenzoate, colors, etc. are also added to the shaving products. Shaving soaps. These are water-soluble sodium or potassium salts or fatty acids. They are formulated by using fats and oils or their fatty acids by reacting them with a strong alkali. The lather produced by the soap is spread on the face by using the brush. Lather provides protection from blade or the razor and generate lubrication at the same time. The main objective of using shaving soap is to wet and soften the hair to be shaved and to decrease the skin irritation during shaving. Shaving creams. They are applied on hair face to prevent skin irritation and to provide lubrication. These creams generally consist of a mixture of fatty acids, surfactants, alcohol, water, and soap. These are available mainly in tubes. Lanolin or polyoxyethylene sorbitan monostearate are emulsifiers used to solubilize the immiscible substances and assist in holding the moisture into the skin. Humectants like glycerin act as moisturizer and lubricant and makes the skin soft and healthy. Brushless shaving cream. It is also possible to prepare a brushless shaving cream without using more amount of fatty acids. Self-emulsifying glycerol monostearate in quantity about 10 to 25% is a suitable emulsifier for non-aqueous phase, and this forms a high translucent cream which exhibits good emollient action than standard creams. An example of such kind of formulation consists of glyceryl monostearate, mineral oil, lanolin, glycerol, stearic acid, potassium hydroxide, and water. Shaving gels. Shaving gels provide lubrication and conditioning to the skin. Ingredients like carbapol is added to the gel, which offers smooth shave as they improve the surface contact. The basic difference between the shaving gel and the cream is the lather which is produced. Shaving gels are fairly thick and there is no need to mix them with water before use, whereas creams are to be mixed with little amount of water to produce a lather. Shaving gel consists of gelling agents for smooth shaving. A typical composition of a shaving gel consists of film forming agents like glyceryl polymeth acrylate, and the maximum content to be used is 10%. Silicones like dimethicone in the concentration range of 5%. Viscosity controlling agents like hydroxyethyl cellulose, the maximum content present should not be more than 3%. Emulsifying agents, surfactants like sodium lauryl sulfate, maximum content 3%. Additional agents like vitamins, plant extracts can be added in not more than 2%. Perfume, cosmetic colorings, preservatives, antimicrobials, and water. Aftershave preparation. An aftershave preparation is used to relieve the irritation and to provide a pleasant sensation of comfort after shaving, which can be obtained by providing emollient, anesthetic, and cooling action. At the same time, the product should be antiseptic. Aftershave preparations are commonly available in the form of gels, creams, liquids, or powders. Aftershave lotion. It is a simple form of aftershave preparation. It is a clear aqueous alcoholic solution which comprises of 50 to 70% of ethyl alcohol. It provides coolness and astringency to the skin. Non-ionic types of surfactants, that is those exhibiting HLB in the range of 15 to 18, are more effective for solubilization of components. To solubilize the perfumes, sugar-based surfactants like sucrose esters, ethoxylated sucrose glycerides are more effective as these lead to less defattening of the lipids than thus imparting less skin irritation. Humectants are usually employed in preparation of aftershave lotions at a concentration not exceeding 5%. Propylene glycol, glycerol, and sorbitol helps in maintaining the skin water content. Amongst these, glycerol exhibits good humectant property. Moreover, propylene glycol is also preferred due to its high solvent property, more volatility, and less viscosity. To provide emolliency, generally lanolin derivatives are used. They also help in solubilization of perfume oil. Alcohol provides cooling of the skin as a result of its evaporation. To achieve astringent action and prevent infections of cut, denatured alcohol and stearate citrate are commonly employed. Menthol is used to numb the damaged skin. The amount of menthol should be kept below 0.1% as it exhibits lacrimatorial action. Cationic types of surfactants are capable to inhibit or kill microorganisms over a wide range of pH. Anionic surfactants are used to inhibit gram-positive and yeast organisms. Among non-ionic surfactants, monoesters formed from polyhydric alcohols and lauric acid comes under the GRAS category and are germicidal. A general aftershave lotion consists of ethyl alcohol, propylene glycol, water, and perfume. It is prepared by dissolving the propylene glycol and perfume in ethyl alcohol. Under constant stirring, water is added slowly in order to avoid precipitation of insoluble or less soluble components. After filtering the solution, it is packed. Crackling foam aerosol aftershave lotion. Aftershave preparation have been developed that are dispensed from an aerosol container as a foam and which provides a crackling sound when subjected to shear during application to the face. This type of composition are said to be oil and water emulsion where the continuous aqueous phase contains suitable emulsifiers and the oil phase consists of the liquefied propellant. The propellant, a fluorocarbon, constitutes 75 to 95% by weight of the emulsion. A typical crackling foam aerosol after lotion consists of diisopropyl adipate, menthol, perfume, turgitol, water, and propellant 114. Aftershave gels. An aqueous alcoholic gel can be formed by reacting carboxyvinyl polymer with the base. The quantity of gelling agent controls the stiffness of gel. An emollient and a cooling agent can be added to aftershave gel. Aftershave cream. Aftershave creams provide astringent action. The formulation used to obtain the soft textured oil-water emulsion are often similar to vanishing or moisturizing creams. There is some advantage to be gained from using soap-free composition in that the pH of the emulsion can be adjusted to the slightly acidic value of the normal skin. The table 8 lists the various ingredients of aftershave cream. Packing of shaving products. Shaving products are usually wrapped or cartoned in single or multi-packs. Stability of product, safety, cost and ease of use are some important parameters which are considered during selection of packaging material. Usually, metal packaging made up of Plated steel and aluminium are used as packaging material. For shaving soaps and creams, plastics are used, although to a lower extent than metals. Shaving creams are also sold in aluminium tubes. In general, if type of packing used for the products are analyzed together, it can be seen that plated steel, plated aluminium, and various plastics are the materials used. Packing should contain detailed instruction for proper use. The packages should be securely closed and should contain the following information, that is, the name of the material, manufacturer's detail, recognized trademark, year of manufacture, batch number, and the ingredients present. The main type of packaging include a tube made up of aluminium or plastic lined with a thin layer of plastic, an external packaging, that is a cardboard material. Multi-laminated is the main material used, followed by other plastics such as polyethylene and polypropylene. About 46% of shaving preparations have secondary packaging made up of cardboard. Different materials used for packaging includes plastic, aluminium, and plated steel. Evaluation of shaving products. The shaving products are evaluated for different parameters. The general requirements. The shaving products shall conform to the general requirements for safety and effectiveness. And the general requirements are moisture and volatile matter, matter insoluble in alcohol, free caustic alkali as potassium hydroxide, chlorides, unsaponified fatty matter, rosin acids, total fatty matter, glycerol, free carbonate alkali, and potassium content. Net weight. The product should contain the quantity as much as it claims. According to the legal metrology rules 2011, the maximum permissible error for preparation up to 50 grams is 1 gram, up to 100 grams is 2 grams. Sensory test. It is a mandatory test for evaluation of ingredients for dermatological safety. In order to determine the post-experience of the product, the sensory tests are carried out. After applying the product, the post-experience like fragrance, consistency, antiseptic action, skin moisturizing quality, and irritation are observed. If product causes any severe irritation, then it is rejected. Skin scratch test. This test is carried out by pressing the formulation between the fingers and rubbing to observe the presence of any coarse particles. In another way, one can spread the product across a piece of butter paper and then observe for scratches. Stability. The preparation should be compatible with the container and the packaging. It suggests that the preparation should not deteriorate during normal storage conditions and use. If there is any deterioration of preparation at normal storage conditions, then it is rejected. Consistency. The consistency of aftershave preparation is very important and should be noticed. The preparation should always exhibit soft textures as well as steady consistency. Homogeneity and spreadability. It is necessary to extrude the preparation from the collapsible tube at 27 plus minus 2 degrees centigrade in a form of a homogeneous mass with the application of normal force starting from the crimped end of the tube. A small quantity of the preparation is applied on the skin and rubbed to evaluate the spreadability. It helps in ease of transfer to the face. So students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Base, fatty acids, surfactants, emollients, humectants, lubricants, cooling agents, perfume, opacifying agents like titanium dioxide, and colors are the main ingredients of shaving products. Pilomotor activity is the potential to cause the contraction of the erectorus pylorum. It is claimed that a close shave can be obtained by incorporating substances having pilomotor activity into the shaving products. Shaving creams produced by using potassium hydroxide alone tend to be less stable. In order to achieve correct plasticity and stability, a ratio of 5:1 of potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide can be used. Oils, when replaced by Carbovax 1500, results in the formulation of non-greasy, brushless shaving creams. Self-emulsifying glycerol monostearate in quantity about 10-25% is a suitable emulsifier for non-aqueous phase, and this forms a high translucent cream which exhibit good emollient action than standard creams. For shaving creams, tubes, jars and bottles are the most commonly used containers. Shaving products can be evaluated for net weight, sensory test, dermatological safety test, skin scratch test, consistency, homogeneity, spreadability, comfort and closeness of shave, lather stability, ease of removal of the lather and shaving debris from the razor, acceptability, compatibility of perfume and effect on the life of the blade. Aftershave preparations are used to relieve the irritation and to provide a pleasant sensation of comfort after shaving and also provide emolliency and slight coolness. Crackling foam aerosol aftershave lotion are generally oil in water emulsion, whereas the continuous phase contains suitable emulsifiers and the oil phase consists of liquefied propellants. Thank you.